All right, here it is. Here's the big one. Now, I remind you, this is important because number one, Rikeda said that Jason closed wanted his body cam footage. That's his public statement. Jason closed only petitioned for the warrant, which is already public information. He did not petition for the body cam footage, so that's a lie, straight on its face. The other thing is that Rikeda is very, very, very afraid in this motion, not this response, this motion to a response motion. He's very, very afraid that if his minor children have to testify, then Jason Close might be looking at them through the television in DC. Well, Rikeda, guess what? Kristen Pierce, the first assistant to the Kandiyohi County Attorney, writes this in regards to Mr. Judge Wenzel and says, "The county takes no position on the motion to audio or video record the proceedings. This case does not involve a victim. If there is not a person offense, and any testimony by minors is unlikely." The county defers to the court's decision. The prosecuting attorney has stated there will be no minor testimony in this case. You have no grounds to sit behind your kids like a coward and pretend that you're just looking out for their own best interest because they're not in testifying and you know that. So this is also Exhibit A in the response. All this shit, this muckraking that he tried to fling around to make everybody on the Kiwi Farms file guilty by association because of this one idiot is moot. And if anything, the security concerns raised by this only bolster the argument that it should be broadcasted and it should not be a public zoo exhibit. I hope you're happy. He's very, very, very smug about this, by the way. But I'm patient, chat. I'm patient. I'm willing to wait and see what happens. By the way, I'll just mention this to get it out of the way. Montegraf or Ricardo was ordered to pay $300 to Montegraf for court fees months ago, and he hasn't paid. So Ricardo is so down bad he can't even afford $300 to Montegraf, who, by the way, is still suing him, and who, if he really wants to, can depose Ricardo and make his life a living hell when he does so. So the omnibus hearing is interesting because, in particular, if they are going to accept a plea, they would have to do so at the omnibus hearing. Now, there's an interesting issue regarding his omnibus hearing. His issue is this: Riceta has an attorney. He hired Mr. White as his chosen representative. Kayla has no attorney. She is currently pro se in the case, and she hasn't actually entered an appearance since she bonded out. She has no representation. Her husband is not her attorney, and she's technically pro se and unrepresented in the case, which is why we know that Riceta or Kayla Riceta has a plea deal. Because ordinarily, when a plea deal is offered, it is given to the attorney representing the defendant, and there is no record of this on the public docket. If the plea deal is offered to a private person representing themselves, not through their representation, the state must file an affidavit that they were served this plea deal, and that affidavit is public record. So we know for a fact that Kayla has received a plea deal. We do not know if April or Rakeda have received a plea deal, but they probably have. If they offered it to Kayla, they probably offered it to Rakeda. So I mentioned that the omnibus is on the 21st, and the omnibus is a very big hearing. All pretrial issues must be dealt with at the omnibus. So everything that she would ever want to bring up before the trial begins must be done before the omnibus hearing. But again, she has no attorney, she hasn't filed nothing, and her appearance is on the 21st, which makes it seem very likely that she will enter a plea deal as a pro se defendant, and she'll just say, "Yeah, I agree to the terms of their conditions." And the cookie cutter plea deal for her charge as a first time offender is 2 years probation. April is also charged, but she has a public defender, so it's unknown if she will accept the plea deal or what her plan is. I have, after discussing this with a practicing attorney, I have a pet theory about what Ricade is about to do. And if he does it, it's one of the most despicable things that a man could ever possibly do. And I don't want to say what it is, because I feel like what I had proposed is so spineless, so disgusting, so cretinous, that Ricardo might actually do it. It's also a 190 IQ move, which a Floridian swamp genius such as myself could come up with. So I'm tempted to write my prediction down and send it to somebody I trust, such as like Sean or Alyssa Clips, just as like an intermediary, someone who would have no reason to lie. So if I'm right, I can say I'm right. And such a craven bitch. I could, and so predictable, just the most predictable craven asshole that's ever lived. I can just see him coming a mile away too. So I might do that just as a fun game. I'm thinking about it. Cause I kind of want to tell you what I think is going to happen. Cause I'm pretty sure I'm right. And if I do, you guys will, if what I believe is true, you guys will be so floored at how unbelievable and shameless Nick Ricada is. It will actually floor you. It'll shock you to your core. Send it to Ralph, Ethan Ralph of the Kill Stream. That's a trustworthy person. If I've ever heard of one, just the name, gives confidence. So. You have good calls. I'll do it. I'll write it down. I'll send it to Sean. And then he can say if I was right or not. That's basically it. There's a big trial coming up on the 21st, and Ricada is fighting tooth and nail to try and get this suppressed. Not only is he trying to get it suppressed, he's also using the opportunity with his absolute privilege to try and smear everybody involved in this case for reasons unknown to me. As I mentioned, it's an ugly and ineffective tactic because you have to understand, and this is why I say this, if you want to go out there, it's a bad idea in general to antagonize an entire community of 12,000 plus daily users. It's a really bad idea to antagonize tens of thousands of people outside of that community who have an interest in the proceedings and who might be sympathetic to that forum. To call them, though, and to try and commit this kind of libel just out of like pettiness and spite is a really good way to piss off tons of people, like more like really piss people off. And it's just like, oh, what a really deserves to get stomped. Like, it's a good way to incite people against you, which is always a bad idea. If you ever invite trouble, trouble will find you. That's how it works. I don't know what he's doing. I mean, I kind of feel bad for him in a way, just because the behavior that we are witnessing is the behavior of a cornered animal, someone who's like primitive brain is taking over because he's a fearful person and he's incapable of taking accountability. And there's a part of me that winces when I see this kind of whinging. It's like so pathetic that it inspires pity. Like, it's not the behavior of a 40-year-old father of five. It's the behavior of like a 16-year-old boy trying to get out of a DUI charge. You know what I mean? It's like,